Nearly as tall as me. We've been cooking together since she could sit on the countertop, and she just loves it. And this is the perfect time. The summer holidays are here. We're looking for things to do. Get in the kitchen and let's teach our children life lessons. Let's create memories together.
Oh, I can tell you're so excited about being able to share with it. We got to talk with May a little bit before we got started. You do enjoy kitchen. You're telling me how you try everything under the sun. I need to take some lessons from you, May.
Aww.
Yeah. You're cooking one of my favorites, you know, this morning, John. What are you going to be cooking for us today? Shrimp, right?
Yeah, so what we've done is we've took the classic coconut shrimp, but a couple of little twists, as we always do. When we look at a recipe, we think, how can we make that just a little bit better, but something we can make at home? So let's get stuck in. The first thing, we've got 11 to 16 size shrimp. For a coconut shrimp, you want them a little bit bigger. When you've got the peeled shrimp, there's always going to be that little bit of extra shell. Let's just take that off. And the reason why we take that off is so you can have all of the shrimp. If you leave that on, it's often wasted inside. Now, we're going to do a thing called butterfly, and don't be scared of this. So all we're going to do is our hands are on the top. We're coming in with the knife and just coming around two-thirds of the way. And now we've butterflied it. And the reason why we butterfly it, when we eat a shrimp, it's going to take longer to cook, but it's very dense. So to help prevent that, we butterfly it, which is quick cooking, and it's going to be tender. When you think about shrimp, it's a protein, just like chicken breast is a protein, so it can dry out. One of the ways we help preventing that, to keep it nice, juicy, tender, is to make a simple brine. Duck sauce. All grocery stores sell duck sauce. I don't work for this brand, just in case anybody thinks I'm trying to, you know, promote this. It's just that any duck sauce you can get in your store, we've taken some duck sauce, some water, and some salt, and we placed the shrimp in this marinade. This brine here works perfect with any fishes you may have, swordfish, cod, salmon. What this does, it helps the protein keep the juices inside. It's called an osmosis effect, and it really is a game changer, I promise. If you trust me on this journey, we let them marinate. We know that shrimp don't need too long because it's a small protein. So 15 to 30 minutes is more than enough. We bring them out and we've dried them. So what we're going to do now is make a batter. And this is really effortless. Just watch. 2/3 of a cup of all-purpose flour, which is a perfect amount for the batter, and baking powder. So I know what you're thinking. What, we use baking powder when we're making a cake, but why would we use it when we're making shrimp? We want that aeration, that lightness in the batter. We don't want it dense. There's nothing worse, especially if you're English and you've got those teeth, you know, these are made in America, so these are fine. You know, but when you get
some... Always have to get the tea, the joke in there. I love that, John.
I'm allowed to say it because I'm English, you know. So we whisk together these. Now, this is an ingredient you can get at most grocery stores now. It's called five spice. Five spice is a blend of cinnamon, star anise, Szechuan peppercorn, and a little bit of coriander. And they really are aromatic. It's one of those where it's almost like Etta James or Barry White is serenading the ears. It has that flavor, you know. So now we're going to whisk these together. Whenever we make a batter, we always want the dry and the wet ingredients, and then we add them together. So now we're going to have one large egg. Whenever we cook, if the egg is room temperature, we're always going to get a brighter cake, a large rise. Whenever we make a batter, it's always going to be more aerated. So we're going to have one large egg to the bowl. And then for this one, you can use beer. You could use a light beer. Or I got this Cayman Jack margarita. I don't work for the brand. I'm just showing you. You could use Bud Light Lime, but it adds that lime flavor to it. So we're going to take some, let's just twist it up and we'll add some of this a margarita mix. And what we're looking for here is that carbonation in the actual mix is going to make the mixture light. So it's chilled. So now watch what happens. As this goes in the bowl, ladies, Look at that carbonation. Look at that fizziness. When you see that, you know this batter is going to be so light. It's going to be fabulous. Look at that. See the fizziness in there? The baking powder is just having a jolly good time. It's drinking the alcohol. Oh, baby.
And have a margarita.
But you can't drink it. Margarita. So here we go. Now watch. Whenever we drink. I'm so sorry, lady. Every time I do these segments, I don't stop talking.
I'm sitting here. I'm taking it all in.
Once a month, bless. Look. So whenever we batter something, we always want to into flour, and this helps prevent the actual batter slipping off. It's important to dress that in, and then we'll go into the mixture. Look at that carbonation. We know that's going to be a light batter. And then in here, we have panko breadcrumbs, which is almost like a sourdough grated, and we have coconuts. It's the sweetened coconut. So when you have this, you've got that spice mixture, you've got the bit of margarita in there, and now you've got that panko breadcrumbs. It's going to be so crunchy. We just place it in there, place this on top. We don't have to push it down too much, just the light pushing, and now you've got that perfectly coated. Just take a look at that. I'm going to show it to you like a fine jeweler. I feel like Liberace about to go on the piano.
John, okay. We have a minute left. Yeah. And I real quickly want to ask when you guys are family cooking in the kitchen, does he have this energy all the time, May? Is this is what it's like cooking family dinner?
All the time. It's nonstop. And it's so funny. He cracks all these jokes.
I was going to ask about the dad jokes. What's better, May, the cooking or the dad jokes?
It's a package. It all comes together. I mean, it makes the food better, honestly.
We've fried these off. I know we've only got a minute. We've fried them off because I want to make sure the oil was about between 350 and 375. Let them cook, and they're so crunchy. Just take a look at that. And we've got a sweet chili mayonnaise. We dip those in there, and now you've got this gorgeous, absolutely delightful, as I smell it, that bouquet from the garlic. And then as I take, I'm going to take a taste for you ladies.
Oh, I want some.
I know. That's my love language right there. Guys, John, we love when you join us. Thank you so much. The recipe, you were so kind to send that to us, so that's going to be on our website as well. Mm-hmm. May, keep them in line. I know it's probably a lot of work. You're doing a good job.
Thanks, guys. See you soon.